Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can create this animation in Blender. So let's get started. Add a plane, go to geometry nodes and click on new. Delete the group input and add an icosphere. Set the radius to 9.5. Add an instance on points node. For the instance, let's use a curve line. Add a subdivide curve node. Set the cuts to 25. For the rotation, let's add a normal node. Also add an align Euler vector node. Use the set. And here instead of the rotation, let's use the vector. Go here and open the timeline. Keyframe the end. Go to frame 250 and set the set to 50 and keyframe it. Add a realize instances node. Also add a set position node. For the offset, let's use a noise texture. Make sure to use the color. Set it to 4D. On frame 250, let's set the W to 20 and keyframe it. And set the scale to 0.6. Go to frame 1 and set it to 0. And keyframe it again. Let's also set the subdivisions here to 4. Add a vector math node. Set the vector here to -0.5. As you can see, if I disable this node, it's going to change the position and we don't want that. Duplicate the instance and points node and put it here. We are now going to use the cuts of each of these lines as the points. Let's use a cube as the instance. Add a subdivision surface node. I'm going to set it to 4 and disable it for now. Now let's put it here. The reason that I disabled it for now is because it's going to be very heavy on the computer. I want these cubes to have the same rotation as the lines here, but because we are not instancing on the icosphere, we can't just use this and plug it in here. Instead, let's add a capture attribute node. Set it from float to vector. Take the rotation and plug it into the value. Now take this attribute here and plug it into the rotation. For the scale, let's add a spline parameter node. Use the factor here. Let's also set the set of the cube to 0.1. Now because we added the spline parameter node, the cubes are going to get smaller as they get closer to the center. If you want, you can invert this by adding a reverse curve node. I don't want that right now, so let's dissolve it. Duplicate the realize instances node and put it here. We can also close this, by the way. Take the set position node and the vector math node and put it here. Take the geometry and plug it in here and press Alt and Shift and click on the set position node. I want this to have some noise, so let's take the color of the noise texture and plug it into the vector here. Add a set shade smooth node. Let's also add a set material node. In the material properties, click on new and select the material here. For this material to work properly, we're going to need the UV map of each of these instances. To create the UV maps, let's duplicate the capture attribute node and put it here. We could just use this UV map, but if we do that, the material will look the same on every instance. So now let's take this value here and add a normal node. Now take the attribute and plug it in here. Go to the modifier properties and click on this drop down here. Now let's press N and go to group, select the attribute. I'm going to call it UV. Now here type in UV as well. Let's go to the subdivision surface node and set the edge crease to 0.315. Save and select the node and press M. Go to the shading tab. You'll have to use cycles for this. Go to rendered view and set the max samples to 384. Under film, enable transparent and transparent glass. Let's also go to color management and set the fusion transform to filmic and the look to very high contrast. Delete the principled BSDF. Add a Voronoi texture. Now let's import the UV maps with an attribute node. Under name, type in UV. Plug the vector into the vector. I made a small mistake here. We need to put the subdivision surface node after the capture attribute node. Now let's go back to shading. Add a glass BSDF. Plug the distance into the roughness. Now add a color ramp. Put the black somewhere around here and the white here. Select the black and now let's set this value to 0.18. Go to the world properties and here under color select sky texture. Set the sun elevation to 7 and the sun rotation to 60. Set air, dust and ozone to 6. Let's also set the strength to 3.5. Save again and go back to layout mode. Go into rendered view. Add a camera. In the object data properties, set the focal length to 6. Go back to geometry nodes. Select the plane and disable the subdivision surface node. Go to viewport shading. Open the timeline to make sure that the camera isn't intersecting with the instances like it is here. To fix that, select the camera. Go here and set it to 3D cursor and press R and Z and rotate it like this. I also just noticed that these instances are intersecting. To fix that, let's change the radius like this. Now add an empty plane axis. Enable snapping and set it to face project. Press G and put it here. Keyframe the location. Now go to frame 45 and press G and put it here. Keyframe the location. Now go up here and enable depth of field. Select the camera, go to the object data properties, enable depth of field and select the empty here. Set the f-stop to 0.1 and the blades to 16. Save again and enable the subdivision surface node. To prevent Blender from crashing while rendering, go up here and enable lock interface. Now press F12 to render one of the images. Now close this window and go to compositing. Enable use nodes and denoising data. Add a denoise node and put it here. Connect it like this. Press Ctrl Shift and click on the node and now press Shift and right click drag over here. Let's put that over here. Add an alpha over node and put it here. Let's use this image here. I'm going to make this orange. Add a glare node. Set it to fog glow and set it to high. And let's also set this to 9. Duplicate the alpha over node and again take this image here and make this black. Go to view and zoom out. Add a box mask. Plug the mask into the effector. Set this to 0.8 and this to 0.4. Now we need a blur node. Set the X and Y to 300. Add a mix node. Now add a texture node. Go to the texture properties. Click on new. Here select clouds and set the size to 0. Select the texture here and set the factor to 0.025. In the output properties, select an output folder. I'm going to use JPEG with the quality set to 100%. Let's also set the frame rate to 30. If you want, you can go to performance and enable persistent data. Be careful with this because it's going to use a lot of memory because the scene is so big. Save again and press Ctrl F12. Feel free to like and subscribe. If you liked this tutorial, then you're probably also going to like the one that is on screen now. I'll see you next time.